I designed this workshop for festival participants where they can have a shift in their consciousness and they can walk away feeling more empowered. So we go through and hold a very strong intention and we work with that. And you sound very relaxing, music that's created for complete ambient states, and the sound helps through the journey. I start by telling a story of my experience with sound and how it transformed my life. So we open up all the energies, north, south, east, west, allow them to come into the sacred space and really allow it to be a ceremony for everyone that's in there. From there, we go into the life visioning process where we go through the four questions. What is my highest vision? What's blocking me from getting there? What qualities do I need to work on? And what qualities do I already have that's going to help me? Life visioning really is we look at the highest expression, you know, of what's possible, so then how to actually potentially manifest it. We're using sound technologies that's designed to put the individual into more receptive states using alpha waves, theta waves, beta waves. This is how our brain functions on a day-to-day. There's different wavelengths. So this music is created to help individuals fall into these states easier, so they can be more receptive to the visioning process. There's the state known as the hypnagogic state, and this is like usually when you're right before you fall asleep, you're kind of like a little woozy, you're not fully awake, you're not fully asleep. In that state, we're usually more receptive to take an idea, and that's a state that we can actually reprogram our consciousness. We're all manifestors, right? If we believe that we have qualities of the whole universe is within us, or there's divine qualities, that makes us a very powerful individual, whether we realize it or not. In essence, we are creating and manifesting regardless of our awareness of what we're creating. We're manifesting something in our life. When we're in those meditative states, with the right guidance, a lot of times it's possible that a seed can be planted that is a positive seed for our own transformation. Does everyone have a shift? No, but a lot of people do have some sort of an aha moment, and that's what we're looking for. It's an experience. I have to say, like, my reality is very different than it was 10 years ago when I found these tools. And I know for a fact that it's been a great, you know, ingredient in my personal transformation.